Hi, this is Phil from PDQ Merchant Enterprises and the ATM Mastermind Group page, and in today's video, we'll be answering the question, do I have to pay taxes, report any of the income, or are all the earnings pure profit? So before we get started, I just want to remind everybody we have an ATM A to Z course that teaches people how to get into the ATM business and earn an ATM income from steps from A to Z. We also have an ATM Mastermind group page for like-minded individuals just like yourself who want to get a little bit more education in the ATM business. It's free and it's free to join. So I have five, always go with five, on tips and tricks on ATM earnings. All right, so tip number one. The question is a result of how are you filing your taxes? So are you an S-Corp? Are you an LLC? Are you a sole proprietor? And that will be how you're going to have to file. So for number two, if we are a sole proprietor, what'll happen is, let's say we make $10,000. So you make $10,000. You're taxed on that $10,000 at whatever rate that you file your taxes at. So if you're in a, for example, if you're in a 15% tax bracket for this example, then you're gonna take an income of $10,000 and you're gonna be taxed at a 15% federal tax rate, which is $1,500. Now, a lot of people set up an LLC. That's not a foolproof system, as we talked about in a lot of other videos. And if you want to know the difference between an LLC, a sole proprietor, and an S-Corp, we did another video on this, so please reference that other video. But for right now, what we're talking about is an LLC just gets you into the game, but you still have to deem when you're an LLC, which way are you going to file your taxes? Are you going to file as a sole proprietorship, or are you going to file as an S-Corp? If you file and you have an LLC, and you file as a sole proprietor, you're still gonna be taxed at that high rate. So keep in mind, and you're in a 15% tax bracket, you're gonna pay 15% of that $10,000. However, if you have an LLC and elect an S-Corp, or you just wanna shortcut the whole thing, I'm a strong proponent of just filing an S-Corp or setting up your S-Corp, then you're gonna, what you're doing is you've got $10,000 worth of income, you're gonna have all your expenses, and then what's left over, now you're gonna pay at, let's say for this example, 15%. So let's say we have $10,000 worth of income, we have $9,000 worth of expenses, and then we have our bottom line number is $1,000, you're gonna pay tax at a 15% tax rate. That's what our example is. It could be vary. If you're killing it, you could pay more. But for this example, 15% tax rate, and now that's $150 in taxes. Again, I don't claim to be an accountant. Please check with your accountant for 100% clarity on this matter. Just giving you examples on when to pay taxes. Number three is you have to give everybody who makes $600 or more a 1099 at the end of the year. That gives them, or what you're doing is you're reporting to the federal government and you're giving them a report that you reported to the federal government that they made $600 or more. Now, if you're a corporation and files an S-Corp and they're a corporation, you don't have to give them a 1099. We here at PDQ, we always give everybody a 1099 because we have heard horror stories where somebody, that, maybe a friend of mine, they forgot to give a 1099 and to that corporation, and what happens is they went through an audit process and they were responsible for those, that company's earnings, and they had to pay the taxes. You don't wanna put yourself in that position that you're paying taxes on somebody else's money. So what we do is we just make it real easy, and we have a company policy that says, you know what, we're gonna file, we're gonna give a 1099 to everybody who made $600 or more. Keeps it simple, they expect that 1099, and we are in compliance with the federal government. So that's what we practice on doing. Number four is state taxes. We've been talking about federal taxes this whole time, but you keep in mind you still have to pay state taxes. So when you're doing your accounting at the end of the year, you still have to pay state taxes on the money that you're making. And number five to the question, do we have to pay taxes, report the income, or is all this pure profit? Anytime you're in business whatsoever, you have to pay taxes and you have to report the income to your federal government. Now, some people choose to maybe run a little low-key or under the radar, but you know what? That always comes back and bites people in the butt. So what we try to do is we recommend that you do everything above board, 100% clear and precise according to federal and state regulations. So to reiterate, this money is not tax-free. There are ways, following the tax code, to minimize your tax exposure, but for the most part, this is not a tax-free business. It is all, you have to report all that income according to your tax code. So I hope these tips are helpful. Always remember to like and subscribe our video below. Always remember we have an ATM A to Z course for like-minded individuals just like yourself who want to learn more in the ATM business. And if you guys have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Thank you very much.